clothes to wear. He got some sheepskins to make him a pair with the fleshy side out and the woolly side in. Oh, they're pleasant and cool, says Brian O'Lynn. Brian O'Lynn had no shirt on his back. He went to a neighbor and borrowed a sack. Then he puckered the meal bag up under his chin. They'll take it for ruffles, says Brian O'Lynn. Brian O'Lynn had no hat for his head. He stuck on the pot that was made out of lead. Then he murdered a cod for the sake of its fin. It will pass for a feather, says Brian O'Lynn. Brian O'Lynn had no watch to put on. He scooped out a turnip to make himself one. Then he planted a cricket right under the skin. They'll think that it's ticking, says Brian O'Lynn. Brian O'Lynn was hard up for a coat. He borrowed a skin from a neighboring goat with a horn sticking out like a codpiece, he grinned. I wish it were mine, says Brian O'Lynn. Went a courting one night. The mother and daughter both started to fight. To compete for his hand, they both stripped to the skin. Well, I'll marry you both, says Brian O'Lynn. Brian O'Lynn went to bring his wife home. He had but one horse that was all skin and bone. I'll put her behind me as neat as a pin, and her mother before me, says Brian O'Lynn. Brian O'Lynn and his wife and her mother, they all lay down in one bed together. The sheets, they were old and the blankets were thin. I'll sleep in the middle, says Brian O'Lynn. Wife and her mother, they all went out a-shitting together. Some shat thick and some shat thin. Wipe it up with a spoon, says Brian O'Lynn.